Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Lost Horizon. So, last time we managed to successfully rescue Kim from the wreckage of the Ford Tri-Motor, and in our search for shelter and civilization, we stumbled across a secret Nazi base, and now we've got to infiltrate it and rescue an officer that Paddock saw being held prisoner. So, let's get to it.
I have no idea what made these holes. Strange.
Bullets, maybe?
What a lovely party they're having. Ah, well. Some of us have to work. The guards' barracks. The truck Kim and I followed.
Is that it? There's the truck. There's a different part
The
of the truck.
truck Kim and I. F the truck Kim.
Excuse me.
It's locked. It's locked.
Why do we have a
The
rope?
rope is securing the tarpaulin.
Oh, that's for that. Okay. Warning sign.
Let's see what that sign says.
Oh, good thing we grabbed that rope before we went down.
Wow, two crash landings in one day. Bad karma. Ah, well, two crashes and no casualties. That's something. Although I dropped some of my gear. Never mind. Let's get out of here.
Paddock? Fenton, can you hear me?
Why is she here?
Kim? Damn it, didn't I tell you to wait?
Oh, stop playing the hero. It doesn't suit you. Of course, I could always just leave you here and go back.
No, no. Just make sure nobody sees you.
Don't fret. What's it look like down there? Can you climb back up?
Not through the tunnel. I've slid down about 10 meters. But there are some passages here.
Shh, be quiet.
Kim?
Well, that didn't seem locked at all. Another keg of beer. Wow, he just left the door open that whole time? Wasting heat.
Kimmy? Is everything okay?
Yep, coast clear. I'll take a look around up here. There must be something we can get you back up with.
Okay, but be careful.
Always.
We already have it. No?
A long, thin rope. My word, a grappling hook. I am so resourceful.
And we still can't use. Okay.
Terribly dark.
You gonna say that
No
about all of
idea
them?
where this leads. That passageway leads straight ahead, and yep, sure enough, it descends into total darkness. This passageway is a little wider than the others, but I still can't see where it leads.
Well, before we start exploring there.
Daily newspapers. Looks like the paper boy around here has his work cut out. I'll take a paper with me. If I need more, I'll know where to find them. There's all kinds of rubbish in this crate. Let's see if I can find something useful in all this.
Okay, let's stick her,
The sign warns of crevasses. Fenton ignored it.
Can we take it?
It's not doing much good here, so I'll just take it with me. He's annoying, but I do hope Fenton finds a way back up.
Uh-oh, don't let him hear that. So we have a log, sticky tape. That might be useful. Gas burner, pot and lid. I like these
Ah,
things.
yes. There's no such thing as the wrong time and place for home economics, apart from perhaps anywhere and everywhere in a male-dominated society.
I feel like they'll go together eventually.
I don't know why I'd want to wrap the tape around the pot. Oh, Fenton is so much better at this stuff than me.
Though I think there are things we can do, but we just don't know it yet.
The warning sign was stuck in this piece of tree trunk.
So, let's just give Fenton...
Watch it, Fenton! If this hits you in the face, you won't get any uglier, but you can still lose a few brain cells.
It's too big. It'll only get stuck.
Okay, so we can give him that.
Watch out!
And I guess we'll give him the rest
Fancy
of the
some
stuff.
Light reading, Paddock. Duck! You might want to back up a bit.
Alright, I think that's everything.
The truck we followed.
She won't go in. And going in the gate's probably not the best option, so we'll just tuck her there. And now let's see what he's got. He's got the grappling hook.
Doesn't make much sense while the burner's off. And even if it were on, all I'd do is...
Okay, so...
Seal up an empty pot. That tape... alphabet soup. My favorite.
I joke, of
course. I prefer minestrone.
An issue at the Völkisches Tageblatt, a Nazi newspaper. The front page is plastered with a photo of German soldiers marching.
Okay, so I feel like we use this as kindling, we seal up the pot so we don't burn ourselves on it, and then we ignite the gas, maybe? But I could be mistaken on all that.
I could use this to glue the record back together. But I'm not sure Josephine would be quite at her best. I cannot and will not do that to her.
Alright, I guess let's explore the passages if there's some chunks of ice.
Some large chunks of ice fell from the ceiling when I landed. I'll grab a few smaller chunks of ice, just in case I come across any fine bourbons on my travels.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank goodness I didn't fall down there. Some of my things weren't so lucky. Not a chance. I can't even see the bottom.
What about the grappling hook? Can we use that? Nope. We don't have our... I don't suppose we can light... Nope. Okay, so I guess nothing else to do but to start going down these passages.
I'm feeling lucky. Let's see where this leads.
Not so lucky.
This place looks familiar. Of course, as an expert scout, orientation is one of many survival skills I possess, which means I know without a shadow of a doubt that I'm going round in circles. I felt a draft at one stage, so there's got to be another route out. There's a time for blind confidence, and that time is when talking to beautiful women, not when hopelessly lost in an icy cave of doom. There's a draft coming from somewhere. That must be the best route out. I just can't tell from where.
He doesn't want that.
I'll put some lumps of ice in the pot. Great idea. Well, it would be if the burner was switched on. That said, I'm not flame retardant. I'd need something to hold the pot over the flame.
Okay,
Okay, let's stick the lid onto the pot.
Better.
Great idea. That's...
Nope. Still wants...
Great idea. That's set.
Do we have anything else in our inventory? Just the warning side, which...
It's too big.
Yeah, it'll only get stuck. So, what does he have? Oh, we gotta give it to... We can't give it to her.
It's too high and icy. I need another way out.
I like how I used all... excuse me, all the duct tape on that. Is there anything else down here?
Thank goodness I didn't.
He's not letting us get Let's here. Won't let us use the grappling hook on anything. We can't just
terribly. There's a time, there's a draw.
Okay, so he refuses to go through anything else. Can we move around in here? Okay, it doesn't look like it. Is there anything else she might be able to throw down to him?
The guards' barracks. I should stay close by, in case Fenton needs something. And I'm sure he will.
Yeah, he definitely needs something.
Daily newspapers. The truck we've...
Except, Oh, we can go back to the mountain.
Fenton needs my help. I'm tempted to just wander off, but I should probably hang around.
Or not.
I better make sure I don't join him.
Okay, so I'm not seeing anything.
It's too big.
How will that get stuck? Come on, if a person can fit through there, the sign can. And she won't give up the document.
These notes belong to my uncle. He recorded everything that happened during his expedition with Professor Hayes in 1922. Some of the text is written in a secret code that only my uncle and I can read. It seems he wanted to prevent anyone else from reading certain information, such as the section where he describes how he and the
map... Okay, that's just a recap of the cutscene from last time, so... Benton should have...
A rope with a hook.
...the tools he needs.
That's enough.
Ice doesn't go with anything else. Gas burner doesn't go with anything else. Newspaper. Not the log. Sure, you can't.
My pockets are getting cold and damp. I don't need any more ice.
I feel like... But no, how is he gonna pass the ice up to her, so... I mean, I get what we're trying to do here, I think. He wants to make steam from the pot so he can follow the draft, but...
Great idea. That said... A gas burner. Looks like it might even be full. Small chunks of ice. There are a few lumps of ice in the sealed pot. An issue at the fog...
Yeah, he can't really use anything else right now.
Not a chance.
I don't know if there's anything he'll use down there. He won't use the grappling hook. I have a feeling maybe we need some of that gear. Using. Did I break this? I didn't think I could, but I'm starting to wonder. Because normally this game doesn't punish you for,
It's too hot.
For doing anything wrong. Or, not this game, I should say, since I don't know, but, the studio that makes this game. You know, with secret files, they never really punished you for doing anything. If you were going to do something wrong, they stopped you. But I'm just... being put to interact with you.
I wonder if I can work out what made these holes. Now I know. Those are smoldering cigar butts melting into the snow.
Really?
The guards throw their cigar butts out the window, which put these ugly holes in the fresh white snow. Filthy habit.
Oh, we gotta use the sign to dig them out?
The next cigar butt is mine.
Good thing they didn't notice the sound was different that time. Alright, maybe this is what we were missing here.
Watch your head down there!
Or don't. Okay, so... Ah!
Okay, so if the smoke follows the draft, I should have my way out of here.
What?!
But with only the fag end of this cigar, I'm not really getting the smoke I need. It's not hot enough. I'll light the burner. It's certainly not my favorite flavor, but it's burning. Okay, so if I just stand here and watch which way the smoke goes... Bingo! It's drifting down the left-hand passage. Ugh. This place smells like Gus's house.
Oh, hey, a pile of shit we can,
What is that?
We can go through and get random stuff.
Hey, a pocket knife. Of course. All the blades are broken off. Why on earth wouldn't they be? I should have known. Oh well, the corkscrew's still in one piece. Someone had their priorities right. I must be right under the camp. The Germans tossed their rubbish into this cave. Building rubble, wood scraps, and other rubbish. Nothing useful. Aside from that, most of it's frozen.
Okay, we still...
I can see the light.
What we need.
Ha! Always wanted to say that. There's a thin layer of ice covering most of the crevasse, but I can still feel the draft. I can't reach it. A pocket knife where only the corkscrew works. Someone's got their priorities right. I value my hands. I need something else.
I need something else. Okay. We use our grappling hook now.
I can't throw the hook through that layer.
We just break the ice. Are we going to use this to, like, propel it up on the ice?
I better keep this for a while. Might work. I'll make a nice little fire down here, and the layer of ice up there will melt away. Fingers crossed. Then all I need to do is work out how the hell to get up there. Although, that may be academic, since most of this rubbish appears to be frozen solid. I better keep this for a while.
You are something else, Fenton. And we go through
I'm
the...
I'm not going round in a...
No, he refuses to even go through the other,
I can see the light. Building rubble...
Please.
I better keep...
Not gonna go through that.
Building rubble...
There's no other parts to this room.
I'll put a few pages up here between the scraps of wood.
Now can we?
The newspapers are burning. Let's hope the rest of it catches. Still, it should manage to melt the ice, provided I've got a few years to kill. Oh wait, I'm on a top priority secret mission. I need a new plan.
Can we put this on
it? Worth a try. Fenton Paddock, physicist. Location? Underground cave, Tibet. Here begins my experiment on the effects of heat on ice. Phase 1. A kettle with ice is heated up. The ice melts. Phase 2. The melted water appears to be bubbling and spitting. I shall call this boiling. Phase 3. Liftoff. Steam is shooting out of the hole in the lid. Conclusion? Water always behaves the same when heated, whether you're in Tibet or in Ipswich. I am a sarcastic bastard when I'm bored.
Okay, that wasn't quite what I thought would happen. I assume that did nothing to the crevasse.
I can't.
Yeah.
Oh. There's still enough water.
Use the water on.
Okay, let's try again. All quiet in the Far East. Water boils, steam escapes through the hole in the lid. Who would have guessed?
We still have...
There's water in the...
Can we put this in there? Well, that's out. Oh, because we lit that.
It's more likely to kill the fire than feed it. No, not again.
Okay, what else can we put in the fire? He won't put the log.
Let's see what I can carve out.
Oh.
Not much, as it turns out. But I've used the corkscrew to pull out the knot.
There we go, so now we can put
okay,
that in there.
I've stuck the wood chip into the hole in the lid.
Now we can use this on
Let's
the fire.
Let's see what happens next.
It should propel the corkscrew out. Put cork out, rather, and break the ice.
The practical side of physics isn't bad. The wooden bullet thing went straight through the ceiling of ice.
Perfect. Now we can hopefully get out of here.
Aim well.
Yay.
That must be the tent we saw from above. I hope our guy's okay.
So there's the crevasse.
I managed to climb up to the top through this crevasse.
Okay, I don't want you to go down again.
Leftover ammunition inside.
Well,
let's see if
useful.
I can use any of this. Well, on the plus side, there's a grenade here. On the downside, it's most likely a dud.
No, but we could get leverage.
Locked.
Fair enough.
There's one just like that standing in front of the gate. Might come in handy sometime, but I have to take care of other things first.
I think it's gonna push us to rescue the officer first. Can we kill him with the corks? No, it won't let us.
Judging by the engine noise and the smell, there are diesel generators in this shed. Judging by the
Locked. Can't use the grenade to get inside. What about the vent?
The generator motor sucks in air through this opening. I can't open the vent.
And close it. Maybe we can't close.
Looks like he's repairing the truck. A portable welding machine. A toolbox. I shouldn't go any further. The guy over there might see me. And then fun time's over.
Alright, can we go down this way?
I shouldn't go any
further. Nope, we gotta deal with the soldier. Okay. Anything else in here?
Leftover ammunition.
But we can't take it out. Maybe we will have to go back and get something from, him. Can we use the pocket knife to... What? Can you use that on the vent?
I can't open the vent.
What can you do, Paddock? It doesn't even give us the option here. Can we go further north?
I can't go any further. There's a guard up in that hut. Granted, he appears to be sleeping. But I'd rather not take the risk.
That's a no. Okay.
I shouldn't go any further. The guy over there might see me.
He's angled away. As long as you stay below these tracks, I don't think he'd actually see you. Unless he turned to look.
Locked.
Okay. And we... First of all...
Corkscrews are for unscrewing corks. Not dismantling military equipment.
Can't we just knock this guy out? Come on, you used to be a soldier. Alright, empty gas burner, nothing.
The generator motor sucks in air through this opening. I can't open the vent. I can't open the vent.
You're useless, Fenton. Well, let's go back down here, I guess. Can we pick any of this stuff up?
Ouch, ouch, ouch! Hot! No, no, and no again. Building rubble.
Okay, all frozen.
It's more likely to...
Doesn't wanna...
There's water in the...
Okay, so we still have
nope.
Water.
Nothing useful there. Point blank refuse.
Oh, wow, okay, so he's just gonna refuse to go back, so we can't get anything more from Kim. But all we have is this freaking pot, which is apparently gonna open the vent somehow.
Water would cause a short circuit. Sounds promising.
You could have just thrown in the ice and had the same effect.
Oh, Mensch, what's happened now? Must be the generator.
What now? He can't stay in there forever.
Take the beam.
Hey, now what's wrong? Hello? Hilfe! Can anyone hear me out there? Something's blocking the door. Hello?
Good thing the generator in the other hut's loud enough to drown out his shouting. A portable welding machine. A toolbox.
Alright. Let's steal
this. It won't budge. The lid seems to be jammed.
Oh, not this again.
Unfortunately, the corkscrew isn't at all suited for prying open the jammed lid.
No. No.
It won't.
I don't think we have anything. Our inventory can deal with that right now, so.
The British officer is being held in this tent.
Oh, let's grab the officer. At least we can do that.
Okay, I'll ask you again. How did the monk and your lieutenant escape the monastery? Which secret passage did they use? We can go on like this for days. I have hundreds of these records, and you seem to enjoy the music. Or surely you would object. If it's still too quiet, I'd be happy to turn up the volume.
My word, it's Thomas. Thomas Finch. He's an officer in Richard's unit. I knew him from the service back in Hong Kong. It looks like they're torturing him with German marching music.
It's booming through his headphones. A fate worse than death. I could deal with this guard if he wasn't as wide as a doorframe. Since I left my black belt at home, I'll have to be a bit more subtle. This guy's a machine. One-on-one, he'd mince me. A tent peg.
You didn't have to stand up to grab it, you know. Alright, is there anything else?
Thomas Finch. He was an officer in Richard's unit. I remember him from my days in the service. He was garrisoned in Hong Kong a few times. I have to get him out of there. He's probably beginning to think in German refrains by now. That's no good. I need him to tell me where Richard is. Good God, where in the world did they breed that guy? A Nazi uniform. Thomas's headphones are plugged into this player. I'll never make it over there without being noticed by Max Schmeling's big brother.
I don't know who that is, but I assume maybe that's like a German wrestler or something.
There must be, conservatively, about 5,000 German marching records here.
Uh-oh.
And now I have something very special for you. Let's see how you like this. Something tells me you'll become very talkative very soon.
I can't get over there without getting caught by Mr. Kick My Ass.
Alright, well, let's get out of here for now. I think with the tent pig, we could probably finally crack open this toolbox.
Yes, I can use this to lift the lid a bit. Let's see what I can pull out through the gap.
A vise, glue, and saw blade in cover. Well, actually, can we go south anymore? No. So let's see what we can do here.
I've unscrewed the top of the grenade and poured out the gunpowder.
Oh god. Anything else in here? Nope. Might come in handy later, but for
a
now.
A buzzsaw blade. I'll take it out of the cover. An empty cardboard cover. Brown, simple, practical.
Ah, I see here.
I've covered the edges of the pieces with glue. Now they just need to go back together. I can pick up...
Oh, come on, I know how to do this puzzle. Okay, so you're gonna go there. Center's gonna be the easiest. I'm gonna go there-ish. The Grammy foam. There. And you'll go there. Now the rest of it is gonna be a bit harder now. Almost fit. Oh, hey, that fits. Cool. So now this has become a little bit easier. It almost fit. Almost. It's gonna be a corner piece of some sort. Let's see here. Oh, perfect, perfect. Yeah, okay, so that fits. Okay, so is it might go here. Nope. Nope. That doesn't quite fit there. That doesn't fit. This might fit. If I can freaking set that piece down. There we go. That's a bit better. I think might be able to get this guy to go there. No, you're gonna go probably there. We'll go there. Okay, so that fits there, and you fit there.
Job done. I've glued the record back together. Of course, the light-colored glue in the cracks won't stand up to scrutiny. At all.
Ah, so that's why we have the gunpowder now.
The gunpowder's sticking to the glue in the cracks. You can hardly see them. The record looks as good as new.
And now we can...
Right. Let's carefully get the record back into the cover. Don't need the cracks reappearing.
Well, the question is, are we just gonna use... Are we gonna use a saw blade?
I could just grab him from behind, but he doesn't look like an amateur. I need to get Thomas's attention and double-team this guy. Of course, he's too busy enjoying German marching music.
Okay, so maybe all we have to do is throw this out?
Without a cover, he'll notice straight away.
It's in a cover!
Without a cover... I'll take the now... Right, let's carefully get the record back into the cover. Don't need the cracks reappearing. Without a
cover... What else do you... Oh...
We could jazz up this cover with that picture of the soldiers from the newspaper. But we need something to stick them together. I'll take the now...
So we use... the glue?
I put some glue on the back of the newspaper page. Now I can stick the picture of the soldiers somewhere. Perfect. We've got marching soldiers on the front cover.
There we go.
Hey, maybe I'll sell this as a collector's item instead.
Now we should be able to...
If I'm lucky, Hans won't notice it's not marches. Something tells me Thomas will.
Yeah, he was afraid about the German guy seeing him take something from there, and yet he's able to put something there with no problem.
Okay, here comes a real smasher.
Well, that worked out.
Yeah. I meant that to happen. Job done. Hope no one heard the explosion. Thomas? Wait, I'll take off the headphones.
Fenton? Fenton Paddock? What the hell are you doing here?
I'll explain later. You have to listen to me now. We don't have much time. Are you okay?
Fenton? You're back with the forces? Where's the rescue unit?
No. Listen to me, Thomas. Is everything okay? Are you injured?
Well, my ears are still ringing a bit, and I'm pretty knackered. They haven't let me sleep for 3 days.
Can you stand up?
Not as long as I'm handcuffed to this crate.
Okay. I can take care of that. I need to know what happened.
I suppose we were in the wrong place at the wrong time.
What do you mean?
Well, our mission was to survey the area. Richard's maps were taking us towards some key defense points. An old monastery set near a valley. It was dark when we got here. The search for the monastery was due to begin the following morning. We were prepping our gear and setting up camp when we heard explosions. The monastery was set on a mountain slope, and we could make out someone trying to blast open the entrance. We couldn't tell, but we assumed they were bandits. Richard ordered an attack. The maps showed a second, hidden entrance to the monastery. So we took a team up and made contact with the monks. We got in touch with the abbot, or whatever they call him, but we were too late. They stormed the main entrance. We were massively outnumbered. Didn't have a chance. The old monk hid Richard and I in a secret chamber. He was scared. Didn't think he'd make it. He told us something we were to remember at all costs.
And what was that?
He said, "The door is guarded by two dragons, Yao the Strong and Zhao the Wise. Zhao, the mother, is twice as old as her son, Yao. Something like that. Anyway, he made it, along with Richard, but I took a bullet and wound up here. I only realized then why we were overrun. Nazis put up a better fight than bandits, I guess.
What are the Germans doing?
What are the Germans doing here anyway?
They found something very exciting in the monastery. But I haven't the faintest idea what it is. In any event, it's important enough to the boss around here, that Countess von Hagenhilt, to slaughter innocent monks. They kept asking me how to open the secret chamber, but I didn't give them anything. I suppose whatever they're looking for is in there.
You mean you didn't tell them anything about this dragon code?
No, not a word.
You know, for not having a lot of time, we sure have a lot of time to question him.
What happened to Richard?
I assume he and the monk made it to the chamber, but I really don't know.
So Richard might still be there?
Maybe, if they had some supplies. But he might even have made it out.
Well, whichever the case, I'm going to find him. That chamber, where exactly is it?
In a kind of courtyard. There's a secret mechanism on the west wall.
Right. Thomas, do you have any idea how we can get out of here?
You're a card. The best thing would be to leave the same way you came, don't you think?
Yeah, we can forget about that. I kind of fell down a crevasse. Besides, you don't look like you're up for any sheer rock faces quite yet.
There are trucks leaving the camp several times a day. Maybe that's an option.
Sounds interesting. Okay, I'll find something to unlock the cuffs.
Might I suggest the key?
The explosion knocked him out, but it takes more than being engulfed by flames to kill a monster like him. A Nazi uniform. Not really my size, but what's this in the pockets?
There's the keys. And the tape.
A tape recording of the interrogation.
Nope, we can't use the saw blade to kill him because even though we were a soldier, we can't use violence.
The German soldier's key ring.
Unintentionally, at least.
Perfect. The smallest key fits. The cuffs are open. Thomas, let's get out of here. Can you walk?
Nope.
I've had better days.
Maybe you better hang here until I can find us a way out. I'll check out the trucks. Get out of here in style.
Alright, so...
I'll put the uniform on first. Blend in with the locals.
Not that truck, it obviously needed repairs.
The truck is a good option, but I'm not leaving until Thomas is on board. There's one just like that.
Wait, do we have to... Oh.
Hey, yeah. I can just drive Thomas out of here. I can hide him in the back of the truck. If we make it past the gate, we're home dry. Okay, Thomas is hiding in the back of the truck. If my luck holds, then the key's in the ignition.
Uh-oh.
Hey, what are you doing there, Junge?
I...
Oh, another one caught the bug. It's this weather. I've had a cold this entire time.
Yeah, I can hardly speak.
Don't worry about it. You wanted to go to the monastery, did you?
Mm-hmm.
Did the men up there order another truck? At this time of the day? I've told those fools 100 times that I will not allow a convoy to drive up there at this time of the day. They better learn to stick to the rules. No truck leaves the base after 1600. Unless they've made a find of utmost priority up at the monastery. What's all this about anyway? What needs to be picked up so urgently?
Well...
What did they say on the radio? Whatever, I just need the military assignment form. Filled out in full. Have them give you one in the radio room. If the finds are particularly important, I can send you up with a truck. I'll be in the barracks. But don't come back unless we're talking really important finds. Otherwise we'll have it picked up in the morning.
Very well. Radio room, form, and important find. Off we go.
There we go, now I have to go back. Will the door be magically unlocked?
Locked.
No. But we have plenty of tools this time around. Like keys. Proper keys.
It's always the last key, isn't it? Door's open.
Actually, can we unlock the... generator room?
None of the keys fit.
Oh, okay. It was worth a shot. That guy's still stuck in there, though.
Thank goodness. Nobody here.
Alright, let's poke around here. Pencil!
There's a pencil on the floor. Messy Nazis.
Funny. Okay. Forms.
I wouldn't have figured the Germans for bureaucrats, but the number of forms here puts our police force to shame. These papers here look like the special assignment forms the guard was talking about. I'll take one with me.
Tape recorder.
A recorder with magnetic tapes. This expedition has more state-of-the-art tech than MI5.
Not MI6, apparently. List. Following artifacts are to be seized. Hey, why is this in English? Dramarcus Scroll, I have Conjure. What do the numbers mean? Is that like a date? Or no, it can't be a date. 35's there.
It's a list of sacred Asian artifacts. That must be what the Germans are looking for at the monastery. I better leave the list hanging there.
Through the Bodhi tree. Bones of Siddhartha Gautama. Isn't that the guy who founded Buddhism? Radio, Morse code.
Not much point without a second recorded tape. Let's hear this recording.
After 2 hours of traditional marching band torture, or oral discomfort treatment, I continue to question him regarding Object 28. He continues to claim he has no knowledge of the item in question. Object 28 is vital to the success of our project. Further questioning scheduled.
Object 28? What project? Cheeky Nazis.
Oh, well, Project Vero, obviously. Object 28 is the Eye of Conjure.
I better leave.
Oh, let's just fill this out.
Which of these list entries is important enough to make the guard approve a special trip to the monastery?
So we have the completed form. So we'll just waltz on out of here. I kind of want to see, can we get into the generator room at all? No, okay. So we'll just head up to the barracks then. Oh, he's sleeping there.
A Nazi uniform.
Where's the form? Where's my form?
I filled in the form with one of the lost objects. I just hope the guards think it's important enough to let me drive off with the truck.
Here you go.
Here's the form.
What? Teufel, what a find! Frau Hagenhild will be thrilled. Los, what are you standing around for? Start the truck and head up there.
Zu Befehl.
And we are out of here.
We can't get any higher in the truck. You'll have to continue on foot from here.
How far is it?
800 meters, maybe a kilometer. The path forks halfway. Head to the left to reach the side entrance.
Okay. You head back down the pass with Kim. Try to make it to the Indian border. When you get there, contact...
Hello?
Yes?
This is one of your terrible jokes, right?
What do you mean?
This is the second time you've tried to palm me off. You're sending me away with a complete stranger? Sorry, no offense.
None taken.
Kim, I've known Thomas for a long time. He's not about to sell you for a camel. I, on the other hand...
Oh, please. Where exactly would you be right now if it weren't for me?
Kim...
Impaled on an agali, stuck down a crevasse?
I'm not saying you haven't helped, but this is no place for young girls.
Oh, of course. I forgot. You infiltrated the German camp all on your own.
I mean, we kind of
did. Fine. My life's achievements I owe entirely to you. Is that what you wanted to hear?
Close enough. So your friend here can just head on down the mountain on his own. Sorry, nothing against you.
No problem.
Fine.
He's taking it well.
Just stop yelling before you bring the whole German army down on us. But I'm warning you, this is not playtime. It's a very serious rescue mission. You'll do what I say, when I say it, and without complaining.
Deal.
You better get going, Thomas.
Okay. Good luck, you two. If I were in better shape, I'd be with you. Look after him, Kim. I'll head for northern India and contact Lord Weston from there.
Good luck, Thomas.
Alright, so he's gonna head south to the border in his very low-resolution textured truck. At least the windshields are pretty low-res. Everything else is passing. And, oh, that's a thing. Berlin?
The upper sign reads Monastery. The next one points down the valley to the camp. The lower two point to the west. Berlin and, Venice?
Bit of humor, no doubt, but we've managed to infiltrate the German camp, rescue an officer, and, well, not an officer, really. I thought the Germans referred to him as an officer, but he only had two stripes on him, which would make him corporal, if memory serves. I know the Commonwealth ranking system is a bit different than the U.S. one, so it might mean something different, but in any case, we rescued his friend, and, managed to get out of the German camp without getting caught. That was a surprise to me. I thought for sure we were going to get caught at some point, but apparently not. So now we're off to find the monastery, but that'll have to wait for next time. So with that, thank you all for watching and stay tuned for next time, and we'll see you then.